God. Okay. So this is a back end Go source, right? So if you see, so it's Gorilla MUX based. So we have the routes, models. Models will map to the database items. So typically a model will have two-way serialization and deserialization. We have from BSON to JSON because MongoDB is BSON, right? And then once we post anything, we have to go from JSON to BSON. So we have this both annotations. So, usually each model is an item in the collection. So that's how we get data from the MongoDB. So those are models. And then we have handlers. For each route, as we discussed last time, right? Each route will have a handler. Now, if you look at the hand routes, we have two types of routes. There is get assets by type, get, and then we have get assets by type as S3 URL. So what we're doing here is when we do get assets by type, we'll get from the database and send it to the browser. If we do get S3 URL, what we do is we'll get from the database and upload that to AWS S3. And then we'll send the AWS S3 URL to the browser. So that way we'll cut down on the number of database calls. Mm-hmm. So that code where we do it is, I'll show an example. For example, say bonds, right? So bonds, when we say get bonds, we'll get everything from the find all. By code S3. Yeah. So when we try to say get bonds, there's a bonds MongoDB collection. We're getting everything in the MongoDB collection. So they are on 5,000 bonds in the database. Now each client, when they hit the browser and they ask for bonds, we don't want to, you know, query the MongoDB that many times. So what we do is we get, there's a database table where we save the pre-signed URL to the S3 prefix where the bonds collection is stored. And then we set an expiry. So within this one day from today, if somebody asks for the same list of bonds, we send the S3 URL. So the browser will get the data from the S3 URL. It will hit the S3. And we don't hit the database. So every day, if you call this way, your database will be called only once because we are caching whatever is in the database to S3. So all that logic is here. So I won't go in details. You can just go by yourself. When you are working on a similar item, we can discuss in details. So now for bonds, I already enabled S3, right? But there are some services, for example, if you see here, for example, assets, I don't think we do S3 yet. Yeah. User assets. Rocket.io. Response. Let me refresh it. Or maybe charts. News. That's in use. Just delete it. Why? Delete. This is the delete. Then the run. Get HTTPS. The response is JSON data. Well, it's not showing the response. Oh, okay. You see, it's sending the collection, right? So yeah, your next task is to prevent it from sending collection, and it should send a S3 URL. So for example, we discussed bonds, right? I'll show bonds, finance. Bonds. Loading. Headers. Yeah, actually, it directly hits S3. It's not showing here, but we'll go in details. If you look here, we send this S3 URL where the bonds list is, and then we query this URL to get the bond data. So that's why you're seeing the bond data, but it has actually been served from S3 as a pre-signed URL. A pre-signed URL is something which only those who have this pre-signed URL can access that bucket. So that way private, we don't make that data public. So that's at the high level. So we went to this, right? Yeah, that's at the high level. So your next task would be to, we have a handler for feet. Yeah, between dates, it's calling the database. RSS feeds database collection and sending it to the client. What we have to implement is cache this. We have the logic in bonds. We'll reuse this logic and make RSS feeds to be served from S3. So that's the goal for the first task. Do you have any questions?
No. So we have to just we have to make S3 objects for it, and we have to give the output of S3, right?
Right.
All the collections.
Right.
Yeah, okay.
So, yeah, that's correct. So you could go through this logic, try to understand what this logic is doing in bonds.go in handlers. When we meet next time, we can discuss in details what it's actually doing. I can explain the logic.
Yeah, that's fine.
For now, this is very high level. So for you to just go through the code, see what it is, what is the next task, etc. So at least you can switch, focus on that part, because AWS is too vast. So yeah, don't have to read everything now. Just on this S3 pre-signed URLs, if you read on that, that's good enough for now. Okay, I'll stop recording. No questions, right?
No questions.
Yeah.